Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to start with speech writing. You are being doing students this speech writing since your class 7, class 8, class 9, then now you are in class 10. So you must have seen that with the you can say moving on to the next level, there are number of changes that has taken place in speech writing level. Okay, it means earlier you are getting easier topics, then afterwards you are getting little you can say tougher topics which are related to daily life. So similarly, in class 10th also you are going to get any topic which is related to your life and which is related to common issues, also some social issues also, and it can be also about some, you can say, right? So different kind of topics of speech writing are there. And it is a very vast, you can say, subject for speech writing. So what actually speech is? Speech is never meant to be written. It is always meant for speaking in front of audience and in front of gathering. And for that, you have to prepare. But from examination point of view, as speaking part cannot be assessed with the written exam, so you have to write down a speech. Before making it to speak, you have to first of all write it down so that all the important points can be taken into consideration. So number of times we have discussed speech writing in class. Okay, so but today I am going to share with you the PPT about speech writing. Okay, so let us have a look of speech writing in the form of this PPT so that you can have a clear idea. Okay, so let us start to have a look over these. Yes, so see what actually speech writing is. What is the purpose of your speech? Okay, so why a speech is written? Are you writing to explain or argue or persuade? Yes, this is very important point in case of speech writing, because you have to take care whatever your topic is, and tone should be according to the topic which is given. Whether you have to explain something to people or you have to argue, you have to present your point, you have to persuade, you have to make people understand that what actually the situation is. So in this manner, you have to be clear about the purpose of your speech. Then also you should know about the audience to whom you are going to deliver your speech, and accordingly you have to choose your words well so that it can please the audience, so that you can also address the audience well, right? Next, afterwards, layout. So layout is also very important. Format, you should not skip out the layout, as it is a formal piece of writing and you stick to the layout. Style, of course, it is a formal style, and moreover how it is to be written, and moreover how it is written, it is always written in the manner of, you can say, formal style without any change. So what are the features of speech? So repetition is there. Okay, you can repeat your words to see features of speech. First is repetition, means repeating of keywords, messages to the reader and remembers them. Try to repeat those words which you want to highlight in your speech writing. Okay, then use anecdotes. Anecdotes means use like short stories which are linked to the speech. It means that you can deliver, you can add on your personal experiences, some stories from daily life also. Why these to be included? It is just because of the reason that they will make the audience involved in your speech. The audience will be involved in your speech, they will relate to your words, and they will listen to what you are saying carefully. Otherwise, if you speak, maybe the audience may be thinking something else while they are sitting on their seat. So if you are speaking a speech, if you are delivering a speech for a competition, you should be very careful about your words and what kind of examples you are going to include in your speech. Next, for that speech writing, you can use statistics. Statistics, use figures, use percentages, use numbers to support the idea. For example, the latest survey has revealed this fact. According to the recent figures and for the past 10 years, there has not been much increase in the, okay, so this kind of figures you will, statistics you will use in your examples. These kind of examples, they are also making your speech effective. It also delivers the idea to the examiner that the child or the student who is writing a speech is having complete and thorough knowledge of the subject. Right? So it is because of this reason that you have to write down some examples, including some figures, some percentages, or some numbers to support your ideas. Then coming up to next is ask rhetorical questions. Rhetorical questions means questions that do not need any kind of answer, which people already know the answer. For example, you say, isn't it? So if you are giving an example and you are saying to them, then ultimately you will say, isn't it? It means already it is understood to them that what the answer is. So these are rhetorical questions, and you have to use these kind of rhetorical questions in your speech writing. And next point is use memorable phrases and quotes. Yes, which quotes? Use memorable. Use some proverbs, idioms, so that will strike the mind of the listeners. They will listen, they will read. Whenever they read your speech in exam or in examination, they will remember that what kind of phrases and quotes are being presented by you. And ultimately, they will relate it to the idea with which you have explained it. Next is controversial statements. Yes, comments that are deliberately intended to give reaction. Yes, you can ask some controversial questions. Why? In order to grab the attention of the audience. You will deliberately, means knowingly, try to ask such kind of questions to which the audience will pose some kind of reaction. The audience will show their reaction, and ultimately you will give answers, and your speech will be more persuasive, as well as you can say understanding by the audience or on the part of the audience. Next is appropriate tone to suit the audience. Your tone should be appropriate. It means that your languages should be appropriate. What kind of language you are using, it should be appropriate. Okay, see what kind of dignitaries are present in front of you, then your tone should be humble one. If your colleagues are there, you can give some arguments also. It depends what to which kind of audience or to which category of audience you are going to present your views. So ultimately, what are the main features of speech? Repetition, use anecdotes, statistics, rhetorical questions, some memorable phrases and quotes also, then controversial statements also, and there must be appropriate tone to suit the audience. So here it is Emma Watson's he for she speech. So let us watch this speech first of all. Just a moment, please. Let us see. Listen this speech. Let me forward it a little bit. Thank you.
distinguish that. Today, we are launching a campaign for the show. I am reaching out to you. We want to add a number of people. And to do this, we need everyone involved. This is the first campaign of the kind that we've done. We want to try and galvanize as many men and boys as possible to be active for change. And we don't just want to talk about it. We want to try and make sure that it's tangible. I was appointed as civil ambassador to the UN Women for 2 years. And the more I've spoken about feminism, the more I have realized that fighting for women's rights has too often been confounded with manhood. If there is one thing I know for certain, it is that this. For the record, feminism, by definition, is the belief that men and women should have equal rights and opportunities. It is the theory of the political, economic, and social policies. The first question is when I was eight, I was confused. I wanted to direct the prayers of the people, but the boys were not. When at 14, I started sexualizing. And at 15, my girlfriend started looking at the school because they didn't want to see my face. When at 18,
yes. So our purpose is not to completely listen this speech. Actually, what points we are going to highlight here is that what you have noticed. What do you notice about how she delivers the speech? There are gestures, expressions, intonation. She's giving pauses, some rise and fall in the speech. Expressions are there. Some words are stressed ones. And where she is also giving the pauses. So ultimately, these are the main points or the main features of a verbal speech. But these things you cannot include in your writing speech. So what is the structure of speech? First of all, opening. First of all, you will bring the audience into argument or a topic you are going to explain. Then in the body, you should have few points where you will focus on each point in one paragraph, in every different paragraph. This is what I'm always telling you, that when you are going to write down a speech, start every paragraph with a different value point. And then ultimately, conclusion. In conclusion, you will summarize the main points of your speech, provide some further questions. In the end, you will provide a question for the audience to think upon, or you can also make an appeal to the audience and end with a final thought or emotion, which is, you can say, giving a point that what you want to say, right? So this is an example of speech we are omitting. Next, opening paragraph. How you will write the opening paragraph. Here we have to focus on this point, that you have to engage your audience. Think about the words which you have to stress. Give proper pauses also, right? And there is no need to listen for these. And ultimately, speech writing is, of course, requires your good language skills. And ultimately, you have to be accurate enough in writing a speech, right? So this is just the layout of speech. So as I have already told you that what speech writing is. Speech writing, it is a formal piece of writing which is written by the writer in order to put forward his or her view. The writer put forward his views, and moreover, the writer presents his ideas, trying to persuade the audience also. So now, various kind of, you can say, tips or useful tips or useful parts of speech you can write down. You can use various kind of expressions. For example, which expressions are to be used? Which kind of expressions are to be used? So, for example, do you know one thing? Do we hardly believe that, or you may hardly believe that? Let us assume as a matter of fact. Okay, then ultimately, isn't it surprising? Isn't it amazing for you? I want to highlight the point here. I want to put forward the point here. And hardly do we ever believe that. Or as far as dash is concerned, so these kind of expressions, try to start your every paragraph with this kind of, you can say, start. Okay, you will start every paragraph with this kind of expression so that your audience will be involved. You should involve the audience. You will ask rhetorical questions to them that will evoke their reaction. They will try to speak. Okay, they will think about what you are going to deliver. So many points you have to take into account. Now we are coming towards the format of speech. Okay, for format of speech, you can start, as we have seen in that video, that there must be some kind of special quote, or there must be some kind of, you can say, special data, students are still entering, and which have to be spoken at the starting so that it will attract the audience. The first point of speech writing is attract the audience towards yourself. So start with quote, quotation, in order to grab the attention, or you can give some data also so that the audience can be evoked or they are forced to think about it. Okay, so then afterwards, how you have to start. So first of all, you have to give formal address. This you know, formal address. For example, worthy principal ma'am, respected judges, and my fellow honorable teachers, and my dear friends. So it means that whosoever is present in the category of audience, you have to address them in order to acknowledge them. You have to give them, you can say, you have to make their presence felt. So formal address, and then you should also know to whom you are talking, and you should also focus upon your topic. Next, afterwards, there will be announcement of topic. Yes, there we must be announcement of the topic. Yes, you will definitely announce your topic about which topic you are going to stand. So, for example, for today, I dash and dash of class dash and dash is going to present here my views on the topic. This will also attract the attention of the audience, that whether your topic is of, you can say, is of importance for them or not. You will first in hand present your topic. Right? So after announcement of the topic, then afterwards we have to develop the topic. Develop the topic. Okay? So in order to develop the topic, there can be different paragraphs. Okay? Development, in which, as we have seen in the video, that we will use statistics, we will use examples, we will use short stories. But before all that, what we have to do, you have to give one paragraph, devote one paragraph to the introduction part. Introduction part means that you will introduce the audience to the topic, what you are going to explain. Okay? Then afterwards, you will make next para of, suppose if it is a problem, okay, give the various reasons why it is happening, okay. If it is any kind of situation, then give a background of the situation. Why this situation, it has come to the present mode, and give a background that these factors, they have led it to this, you can say this scenario. So in this manner, you will give various reasons. And naturally, in case of speech writing, don't forget that you will speak both in favor and as well as against the topic. In case of debate, you are bound to speak only on one side. You either speak in favor or against, but in speech you are free. You are liberal to give your viewpoint. Okay, you are free to express your viewpoint, and for that you will give some advantages. Before advantages, let us take one para. Okay, in this para you will give some examples, some statistics. Okay, these are of course very important when you are going to write down a speech. So for speech writing, it is important. Students are still entering. I think some problem is there in their connection. So it means that when you will give examples, you will give statistics, the audience will deliberately, we have read the word deliberately, they will deliberately pay attention towards your viewpoints. They will listen to you, what you have said, and they will definitely, you can say, pay attention to your viewpoint, because the ultimate reason of delivering a speech is only to grab the attention of the audience, because you are going to put forward your point in front of audience. And if audience won't be involved, then there is no fun of speaking. Okay, there is no fun of delivering a speech. So the first main point is that you will involve the audience. Then you can also give advantages if it is having. Make one para for advantages, as space is less, so I'm writing in this manner horizontally. Okay, write for advantages. As I told you, advantages, merits, positive points. Okay, so if you are talking about advantages, so the next point is that if you are talking about on one side, a coin always has two sides. So in the next para, you can also speak about disadvantages. Okay, so what you will speak about disadvantages also. So if advantages, disadvantages are there, you will definitely give your suggestions. You will give suggestions that what is your viewpoint, how this can be made up to the mark, how can it be improved. Okay, so your suggestions, they are of great importance, because this is the point where you are putting forward your new ideas. Okay, this is where you are presenting your brain, you are presenting your intelligence. Yes, this is the only point where you are different from that of the other speakers, right? So when you have given, so ultimately we will move to winding up. In winding up, what you will do, that you will wind up your topic. Okay, you will start summarizing your points. Okay, but remember, in that winding up, you will not repeat your points again and again. Just remember this thing. Okay, so when this is done, naturally, finally, everything has an end. So come up to conclusion. So when you will write down conclusion, what you will do here, you will make an appeal to the audience, or raise some question which make the audience to think upon. Okay, so leave a question for the audience to think upon, or make an appeal to the audience so that they can pay attention. Yes, this really has to be done. If this is done, if this your speech make the audience to think, then ultimately your purpose of delivering the speech is complete. Okay, So this is what you are writing for number of years, and this is how a speech is written, right? So I hope that everything is clear to you, right? Now coming up to the question part, as you have to write down a question, I'm giving you on the board. I'm writing on the board for your convenience. Pay attention. So write down, traffic jams on city roads have become quite common these days. Write down traffic jams on city roads have become quite common these days. It has become quite common these days. This causes number of problems to the commuters. Commuter means persons who are driving. This causes many problems to the commuters. This has caused much problem to the commuters. And you have to write a speech on the nuisance of traffic jams. The topic, nuisance of traffic jam, right? So just you can say less time is left. Immediately we can have the idea what points to be included here. You will have, first of all, for example, drive slow, drive safe, these kind of slogans at the starting you can have. Then ultimately you will have a formal address. Then you will have announcement of the topic. Today I dash and dash is going to speak on the topic this. Okay, so what are the reasons? Okay, coming up, first of all, you will give introduction that today, these days, number of road accidents, they have increased daily, day in and day out. We listen to number of, or we read number of news in the newspapers, and every front line, for every newspaper, the front line is that this is happening or that is happening, right? So in this manner, you will write down. And what are the reasons? Coming up to the next paragraph, okay? So they are supposed reasons that they are, have increased number of vehicles, number of vehicles. Then there is also stray cattle. Then this is also underage driving. Okay? People are driving at lower age. Speed is a thriller to everyone, right? Then ultimately, disobeying of rules is also there. Disobeying, people don't obey the rules. Okay, this is also one of the reasons that they don't obey the rules. Okay, and ultimately you can say heavy rains. Because of heavy rains also sometimes the traffic is there on the roads. So you will explain them in one or two or two different paragraphs. Then afterwards, what you have to write down, then you have to come up to the various kind of solution. Okay, for example, if number of vehicles is there, carpool must be introduced. Okay, people should be willing enough to use carpool, or they should use public transport. Okay, special cages, or special, you can say, dwelling places for stray animals. Okay, they must be there for, you can say, stray animals. I hope that now it is visible on your screens. Okay, then the roads must be wider, and the roads must be clean, well maintained, okay, without any potholes, right? And there must be more traffic policemen in order to control so that the offenders can be caught. Offenders means who are breaking the laws, and they should be given heavy penalties to pay, and special enclosures for stray cattle. This I have discussed. Okay, so in this manner, include all these points, then wind up your speech, and finally give conclusion that the time is no longer far away when we have to put all our cars in our homes and have to go on foot to each and every place like that of ancient time, because excess of everything is bad. We need to think about this problem, and it has to be tackled at this time, right? So with this, the speech writing is complete, and after that, now I'm going to take the attendance. You have to write down this speech in your fair notebooks.